8 a.m. the morning of the big match, and the exodus of fans from Fratton Park had begun. Amid a carnival atmosphere, 20,000 Pompey supporters of all ages boarded coaches, trains and cars for the trip to Highbury. Hopes were high that Portsmouth could reach the FA Cup final for the first time since 1939. The Pompey chimes were soon echoing around North London. Outside the home of Arsenal Football Club, Jim Smith's Blue Army gave their team a rousing welcome.
Around 40 coaches left Fratton Park. Altogether, around 80 coaches and myriad cars left the city, destination Highbury. Fans of all ages, shapes and sizes were there. The bizarre, the ordinary, even the well-known.
What could you really make a case for Portsmouth winning today, Gary? The ref, I think, got hit. You see the crowd coming out there now, and we've got two fullbacks who can attack. We've got two wide men at Portsmouth, in Anderton and Chamberlain, who are playing today. Now, the problem, who can get forward and score a goal, but I think Portsmouth will go for the throat.
I understand that Anderton is a player that Liverpool wouldn't mind having on their foot, so...
I think they'd have to pay a lot of money for him.
Yeah, they won't want him to play well today, though, will they? And it's a fabulous atmosphere, and if you don't like football today, you're in the wrong place, because it's football all the way for you. After this one, we're off to Hillsborough for the other semi-final. But now, let's join our commentary team for this match, Trevor Brooking and John Watson.
Thanks very much, guys. What a lovely day for a semi-final. Clear sky, football looks forward to its own strong double. And a smooth playing surface down there, as Highbury almost a throwback to the old days, isn't it? They lad walking around there with the Stranger's uniform on. Because these 17,000 Portsmouth supporters, as you said, Desmond, are having a day out they won't forget, no matter what the result. They probably don't remember Portsmouth playing here in three previous FA Cup semi-finals, in 1929, 1939 and 1949. They haven't been as far in the FA Cup for 43 years. Whereas Liverpool, who have 24,000 fans here, they are playing their sixth semi-final in their last eight seasons. So there's quite a contrast in the way these two clubs have developed over the past few seasons. Liverpool has really only known success, and Pompey have been in all four divisions in living memory. Well, let's have a look now as the fans give tremendous flavour to the day.
And now it's Rush. Warren Neal.
Oh, that's a good looking ball. That's Anderton. A real chance for Pompey. Darren Anderton. It's there. Portsmouth are in the lead of the semi-final. And it's the 20-year-old prospect, Darren Anderton, who goes through the middle to score. How poorly he takes the chance. Warren Neal with the blue ball. That is precision. Wright couldn't get across. Out, and Anderton aimed it, Robillard got his hands to it, and it went in the corner.
Great pass, wasn't it, by Warren Neal. Darren Anderton, a lot of time, I think, to think about where to put this, kept it there.
He did it inside on his right foot. This is Nicol, Steve Nicol, a good run. Oh, he thinks it, and the author. Walker holds his hands up. He's not one of the players who's previously been booked. But there's no need for Nicol to demonstrate with the referee, who saw exactly what happened. So we've now got at least our sixth yellow card of this semi-final.
Good position for John Barnes, left foot as well over the ball.
This is the danger. The curler from Barnes. Michael Thomas is standing to his left as well. Denison, who might fancy blasting one, is also in proximity, but Barnes is the man here who they'll be frightened of. He's saved many a match with his free kicks. Thank you.
State reception was extraordinary, and the second division side had by far the best chances. Alan McLaughlin was denied by Liverpool goalkeeper Bruce Grobbelaar at his most acrobatic 5 minutes before half-time. And from the corner, Portsmouth again came so close to scoring. McLaughlin's backheel and Colin Clark's header both blocked by Roy Houghton on the line before Grobbelaar scooped the ball up. Goalless after 90 minutes, the match went into extra time, and Pompey's Darren Anderton came into his own. Just missing here, but with 10 minutes left, he pounced on a great through ball from Warren Neal and beat Grobbelaar to send the fans wild. The clock ticked away, just 3 minutes to go, and he offered trip Steve Nicol, and John Barnes stepped up for the free kick. It struck the post and Ron Whelan tapped it in, 1-1 the final score. To be so near to, yet so far from Wembley, left many fans disappointed.
I've never seen Pompey play so well. So bad in the third quarter. Thank you. Lucky old Liverpool.
Pompey's goal scorer, Darren Anderton, who later met his girlfriend Kerry, hid his disappointment well.
We defended well, got the goal, and then give away a silly goal, really. So,
how do you feel when Darren scored?
I burst out crying!